Hello, today I'm going to show you how to align and distribute objects using the Align panel. I will go over all these options. If you are interested in a particular subject, please skip to the next segment. I have listed the titles with their timestamp in the description below. Before we can use the Align Panel tool, first we need to select one or more objects. As soon as an object is selected, the Align button will appear at the top toolbar. We can choose how to align or distribute objects and what to align them to. We can align them to Selection, Key Object, or Artboard. If the Align Panel button is not showing, go to Window and select Align. You might notice that the additional options are missing. If this happens, click on the triple bar symbol in the upper right corner and select Show Options. We can choose to align object horizontally left, center, and right, or vertically top, center, and bottom. Before we can align our object, first we need to select it. Next, we need to plan ahead how we would like this object to be aligned. Let's say we would like to align this arrow to the left edge of our artboard. First, choose Align to Artboard, and then select Horizontal Align Left. Let's undo it. If we choose to align it horizontally to the center of the artboard, we would choose Horizontal Align Center. And so on. Let's say we would like to align it to the exact center of the artboard. First, make sure Align to Artboard is still selected, and then choose Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. If we select more than one object and then choose Horizontal Align Left, for example, all the arrows will be aligned to the left edge of our artboard. Let's undo it. If we choose Horizontal Align Center instead, they will be aligned horizontally to the center. And so on. To align object to selection, we need at least two objects. First, we need to decide which objects we would like to include in our selection. We can select three arrows or two. When we select our objects, Illustrator creates a bounding box around them. This is the selection area. Next, go to the Align to pull-down menu and choose Align to Selection. Now, any Align option we choose will be applied only to this selected area. We can align them vertically to the top of the bounding box, bottom, horizontally left, and so on. To align object to a key object, we need at least two objects. Before we choose Align to Key Object, first we need to decide which one of these objects we want to be our key object. The key object, or we can call it the main object, will be the one that won't change its position during alignment, and we can align the other objects to it. If we select all the rectangles, then open the Align to pull-down menu and choose Align to Key Object, Illustrator automatically chooses the key object for us. In this case, it is the red rectangle. You will notice a heavier outline around it. Now, with the key object selected, we can choose any align option we like. Let's choose Horizontal Align Left. You will notice that the key object, the red rectangle, didn't change its position, and the other two rectangles were horizontally aligned to its left edge. Let's undo it. If we would like to choose a key object ourselves, first make sure that all the objects that you want to align are selected, and then click on the one that you would like to mark as the key object. Now select any align option you like. Let's choose horizontal align center. You will notice that our key object, the yellow rectangle, didn't change its position, and the other two rectangles were horizontally aligned to its center. Let's do it one more time. With everything still selected, this time click on the blue rectangle to mark it as the key object. And then choose horizontal align right, for example. Now our key object, the blue rectangle, didn't change its position, and the other two rectangles were horizontally aligned to its right edge. In this example, we would like to align the top anchor point of the yellow triangle to the top anchor point of the green triangle. It is impossible to do this while the snap option is turned on. We could select both anchor points using the lasso tool, then right-click, choose average, and use both. This, however, will bring the selected anchor point to the center between them. Let's undo it. To do it right, switch to the direct selection tool, go to view, make sure all snap options are unchecked, and then drag the top anchor point down. The anchor points will be aligned when we see the two tiny overlapping squares and the on text next to the cursor. Let's undo it. We can also align the points using the align to key anchor point function. Align to key anchor point won't work if one of the objects has all their anchor points selected. So be sure to select only two anchor points that you would like to align. The second anchor point we select becomes the key anchor point, and the first anchor point will be aligned to it. If we select the bottom anchor point first and the top anchor point second, the top anchor point becomes the key anchor point. Let's choose vertical align bottom. You will notice that the green anchor point was aligned to the yellow anchor point. Let's undo it, and this time select the yellow anchor point first and the green anchor point second. If you are having trouble selecting the second anchor point, turn on the preview mode. Now press and hold down the Shift key and select the second anchor point. Then choose vertical align bottom. When we hover over an object, a thin outline around it appears. This is a path. By default, Illustrator creates alignment based on an object's path. If we click on the object to select it, you will notice a bounding box around it, with little control points that we can use to resize or rotate the object. Let's create a copy and apply an effect to it. When working with objects that have an effect applied to them, we can use the edge of the applied effect to calculate alignment instead. If we select both objects, then choose the pink rectangle to be our key object and align them vertically to the bottom, Illustrator automatically aligns them to the bounding box outlines. You will notice that the effect we've applied extends beyond the bounding box. Let me add this blue guideline. Now I will show you where the option is to align the edges. Go to the Align window and click on the triple bar symbol in the upper right corner. Then select Use Preview Bounds. You will notice that Illustrator extends the bounding box to fit everything. Let's select both objects, set the pink rectangle to be our key object, and then choose Vertical Align Bottom. Now the bottom edges are aligned. The Align panel allows us to distribute objects as well. Vertical Distribute tab, Center and Bottom, and Horizontal Distribute left, right and center. We can distribute objects and align them to the selection, key object or the artboard. Let's choose the artboard. Now select Vertical Distribute Center. You will notice that all circles were vertically distributed to the center along the artboard. If we choose to align them to selection instead, and then choose Vertical Distribute Center, they will be vertically distributed to the center along the selected area. Let's change their position. Select All and choose Align to Key Object. A key object is the circle with a heavier outline. Then select Horizontal Distribute Center. Now they are horizontally distributed to the center of the selected key object. If we select the green circle to be the key object, they will be horizontally distributed to the center of the green circle instead. To use the distribute spacing function, we need at least three objects, and they have to be selected. Distribute spacing allows us to create an equal space between the selected objects. We can choose to distribute them along the selection, along the key object, or along the artboard. Let's choose Align to Artboard and then Horizontal Distribute Space. Illustrator distributes the selected rectangles horizontally along the artboard and creates an equal space between them. If we choose Align to Selection instead and then hit Horizontal Distribute Space, the rectangles will be distributed along the selected area with an equal space between them. We can also assign a specific distance between objects that we want to distribute. Here we have a 120 pixel gap between the green and red button, and we would like to create an equal gap between the red and blue button. To do this, select the blue and red button and then click on the red button to mark it as the key object. The key object will remain in its place and the blue button will be distributed to a value we specify. You will notice that the Align window now is giving us an option of changing the spacing value. If we type 50, for example, Illustrator will create a gap of 50 pixels between the selected objects. If we type 5, the gap will be even smaller. To match the other gap size, we need to type 120. Now they are distributed evenly with a 120 pixel gap between them. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.